Hello students, in the previous session I have started a new chapter, that is nutrition in animals. As you know that animals show heterotrophic mode of nutrition. In that class I told you about nutrition, that what is nutrition. Nutrition is a process of taking in food, its digestion, absorption and then utilization of the nutrients in the body. The whole process is known as nutrition. That means you can say that nutrition is a process which is combination of five different steps or five different processes. All these five processes combinedly known as nutrition. These processes are ingestion, taking in food, digestion, changing that food into simple form, absorption, mixing of that food into the blood, and assimilation, utilization of that absorbed food, and finally ejection. That means throwing out the undigested food from the body. So first of all, we will talk about the ingestion. Ingestion, it means putting food inside the body. Different animals are there. You know that on the variety of animals are present. So the process of ingesting food inside the body, or you can say putting food inside the body, is also having very different varieties. So in this slide or in this session, we will discuss about that. Different organisms take food in different ways. The taking food mechanism or the way in which the food is taken inside the body is different from animal to animal based on the food habit or the feeding habit of that particular animal. Just like a hummingbird sucks nectar of plants. Hummingbird, the smallest bird, it sucks nectar from the flowers. The same process is found in the butterflies also. They also suck nectar of flowers. As you can see here, this is the hummingbird and it is sucking nectar from the plant or from the flower. So this is one mechanism or one mode of ingesting food inside the body. Human beings use their hand to put food into their mouth and swallow the food after chewing. We are how we take the food. We put the solid food inside our mouth by using our hand and then we chew it with our teeth and then swallow the food after chewing. So this is the way in which human being ingests the food inside their body. Next is infants of human and many other animals. They feed upon their mother's milk by sucking them. They suck the milk from the mammary glands of their mother. This is the way in which they take their food. Infants of human being and many other animals, they feed upon their mother's milk by sucking them. The next one is a snake. A snake swallow the animal they prey upon without chewing them. That means the whole animal is swallowed by the snake. As you can see here, the snake is swallowing its prey. What do you mean by prey? The animal on which the hunting animal is depend for its food is its prey. Usko uska prey bolte hain. So the snake swallow the animal's whole as a whole. The full animal is swallowed by the snake, and then after that, inside their body they get digestion of the animals. So snake swallow the animals without chewing them. The frog captures prey with its sticky tongue. This is the tongue of the frog. It keeps its long tongue inside its mouth in the rolled way. And as our tongue is attached from the backside in our mouth, but the tongue of frog is attached forward side in its mouth. The tongue is attached to the forward side of its mouth. When it has to catch the prey, it release the tongue with pressure and then capture its prey. So a frog captures prey with its sticky tongue. Different other organisms are also there, like earthworm. It uses the muscular pharynx to swallow its food. It also swallow the food by its mouth. It also swallow its food as its whole. It doesn't chew it. Without chewing, the earthworm swallow its food. Spider weaves a sticky web in which small insects get stuck. All of you have seen the web of a spider, na? In that web, the small insects get stuck or they caught in that, and then spider feed on them. Some aquatic animals filter tiny particles floating nearby and feed upon them. Some aquatic animals are there which allow water to go inside their mouth, and then they release the water out and filter the tiny organisms which are present in that water and feed on them. So this is the way in which some other aquatic animals and spider feed. Now, this is amoeba. What is it? It shows a unique type of ingestion method. Amoeba is a unicellular animal. That means its whole body is made up of one single cell. It engulfs, means put inside the food, engulf tiny particles of food by using pseudopodia. Now, what is it? What do you mean by pseudopodia? Pseudopodia is this. As you can see here, it has its outgrowth, finger-like outgrowths from its body. These finger-like outgrowths of its body is known as pseudopodia. Pseudopodia word is made up of two words. One is pseudo, that means false, and podia means feet. In turn, you can say pseudopodia are also known as false feet. So amoeba is a unicellular animal. It is having irregular shape. The shape of its body is not fixed. It can change the shape of its body. So when it senses food, like this food is here, when it senses food, it arises pseudopodia from its body and surround the food. Wo food ko surround kar leta hai. And amoeba surrounds the food by pseudopodia and then make a food vacuole to engulf the food. After that, as you can see here, around this food, it forms a food vacuole. It surrounds the food particle with its pseudopodia and it make a vacuole, which is known as food vacuole. And now its body is changed and the food is now inside the body within a food vacuole. As you can see here, this is the food vacuole, and in this food vacuole, food is now captured. Now this food is get digested and mixed in the body of amoeba. So this is a way, unique way of taking in food, which is shown by the amoeba, which is a unicellular animal. Unicellular animal means the whole body is made up of one single cell only. How it feed? It feed with the help of pseudopodia, which are also known as false feet. So these are some methods by which animals take in food on which they feed upon.